lovely day to be swimming, so let's dive and get the box. It's just here. It's one of the advantages of having the treasure inside. Welcome back, my friends, to another episode of 7 Days to Die, where we are playing the mod Undead Legacy. Let's continue from where we left off. As you can see, my base underground, it's starting to get much more space. We need to remove just these two blocks and we will have a nice room inside, and after that I can place much better all of these crafting tables. What do I have in store for today's episode? We are going to do a couple of things. I think today is an airdrop day, so we are going to get the airdrop. I want to try to build new guns if possible. I'm going to check out what kind of weapon parts I have and to see if I can build any kind of new weapon. And I also would like with you just quickly check this new what we are playing mod version Undead Legacy mod 1301, I think, and it's a big change regarding the last update. So I'm going to check a little bit with you what kind of the new stuff we have in this mod. So I'm checking right here in the second monitor. We have all POI doors are acceptable to lockpicking, so we can, instead of destroying them normally with tools, we can use a lockpick to open them. I think at least it's what this patch note says. But again, the patch notes are huge. We have a lot of changes, but I'm going just to check the more important ones, and I will leave a link in the description to the forum post where you can see in detail all the changes that were executed in this version of this mod. So all POI doors are settled to lockpicking. We have 33 new items, new beverages, alcoholic, caffeine, energy and sodas. We have broken worker helmets, glass tubes, steel hunting knives, titanium hunting knives, steel machete, titanium machete, steel club, titanium club, steel wrench, titanium wrench, and various sport medals, silver trophy and gold trophy. So that's the new items that we are going to get if we look, or at least probably some of them can be also, we can also buy them at a trade. There are a couple of balancing stuff, nothing too important. I have one here that I like really much. In the smithing table, iron ingots can now be crafted into 20 scrap iron, previous 10. So you have seen me complain in the last episodes about how difficult it is to get iron. With this balancing, it gets a little bit more easy. A lot of info about L points of the cars when we are wrenching them. Nothing too important. You can change. You can see that in the description. We have wrenches. Now there is a steel wrench that is a little bit better than the iron one. And let me check window boards. Faster crafting speed for wood frame blocks. Also a nice change, because it was another thing that I was really complaining. Wood frames, it would take really really long time to craft them. So they increase the speed of crafting the wood frames. That's nice. Gun safes now require 3 lock picks instead of 4. Nothing too special. New cola bottle, and I think that's it. One of the important changes, they implemented a quick fix for the Blood Moon, by another foreign user. What it happens is, for instance, we and I can show you. Let's see game stage. For instance, let's imagine that this 124 game stage generates 50, 50 zombies to kill in the Blood Moon. After you kill that 50, 50, after you kill that 50 zombies, the Blood Moon stops. So, well, as you have seen in my last in the day 14 Blood Moon, we killed all the zombies that were supposed to appear, and we got a nice time off in the rest of the night. What this changes is if you kill that, for instance, that 50 zombies too quickly, and it's not 4 a.m., you will get another 50. And if you kill that 50, and if it's not 4 a.m., you will get another 50. So if you have a nice base and you kill zombies fast enough, you will keep getting the same amount of zombies that you would get with the game stage that you are on until we reach 4 a.m. So what that brings to us, it's a nice Blood Moon with zombies coming constantly without being stopped, and we cannot and after we kill all of them, we will have always stuff to do. So if we kill them faster, we get them more. If we don't kill them faster, we get just the original horde, and that's it. So it's really nice to have this update. Even though I'm going to increase the difficulty for the next Blood Moon, we will get that change because we have that in this patch. I'm always updating to the latest patch. So, but even so, I'm going to mess with the XML files, and I'm going to increase also the Blood Moon count. Sorry, the I'm going to increase the difficulty level by increasing the game stage, because game stage is calculated by the number of days that you don't die and stuff like that. So I'm going to increase that variables artificially. So I'm going to get a really nice value for the next Blood Moon. For the fun killing these guys. Let's go to our base and see if we can build any kind of new toys for us. By new toys, I mean guns. It's one of the stuff that is in my to-do list for a long time, and since it's a never-ending story to sort all the stuff that I get looting, but I'm recuperating stuff. So I can sort more stuff than I loot. So it's a matter of time until I have all of this stuff sorted. So some common, and yeah, as you can see, I'm starting to get a grip on all of the stuff. So soft and common, it's this guy. I can scrap this one, and plastic juicer junk common, it's over there. That's nice. Okay, so guns, let's see if we can get any kind of guns or not. Shotgun stock, let's shotgun long barrel, shotgun. Let's start with the shotguns. So pistol, hunting rifle, shotgun stock. We have a lot of really low quality ones, but for now it's better than nothing. And if I sort some of these things out, I can see what kind of weapon part I need so that I can look for them in the trailers. So if I have all of these unsorted, it's really difficult to know which kind of part of weapon I need to buy. So probably I won't buy anything. Over here, temporarily in my ammo box, I have all the full guns This is not a full gun. All the full guns that I have been looting. So we have 5 guns. Let's see if I can shotgun stock. I can assemble. I need a receiver. I have here a receiver. I don't have any kind of parts and a long barrel. And I have here a long barrel. Close shotgun parts. Can I have any kind of shotgun parts? Yes or no? I haven't seen them. Yes, I have. I've just missed them. So let's again. Where did I assemble it? And we have a nice shotgun ready. Awful quality, almost broken, but we have here a full gun, pistol, sniper rifles, M05. I have here an elite sniper rifle stock, a receiver. This one, it's the same. I can also combine all of this stuff. We have here a full gun. What can I also build? AK-47 barrel, hunting rifle. I don't think I have any sniper barrel. Let's assemble it. We have the parts. We have the stock. Nope, not this one. Probably I need all elite for this stuff. So let me just check again. So no, I need all the other stock, and I'm missing the rifle barrel. So it's not complete. At least for now, I know that I need to buy a sniper barrel if I see one, which is also useful. Let me just place over here all the stuff that I want to store again. This weapon is incomplete, but that's okay. We have sniper rifle parts M20, M05. It's all variations. Compound bow, I don't want. Let me see. AK-47. What do I have again? I should afterwards, and I'll do that between videos, see if I can build a better one. I'm using this one, but this receiver probably is better than the receiver that's here. So barrel, receiver. Do I have here any more stuff? SMG, AK-47 stock, and parts. I think we have all the stuff that we need for the AK-47. SMG. I should split hunting rifle. It's complete. Let's start it. The other side. I should have a box for each kind of weapon. It should be easier, but for now it's more than enough. I'm going to assemble this one. I also have a lot of flashlights, so. And we have another AK-47. It's even better than the one we have. A little bit less quality of the repair, because it doesn't have 100% repair. It's not 100% repair, but that's nice. And let me just show you. I have here in the tools a lot of flashlights to place in all the weapons. I'm going to do that afterwards. So I'm going to store the sniper rifle here. With all of this, I got a little bit more of space. And can I get any kind of SMG? Barrel, receiver, revolver parts. No, SMG, sniper, pistol, shotgun, pistol, SMG. We are not SMG parts. I don't know if they are compatible or not. It's not yet SMG time, I think. Let's just assemble it. Wow. Can I want to assemble the M30. Man, this is and just need an SMG stock. Almost, almost. I need a stock for our SMG clubs. Let me place over here the incomplete and assemble. And I also need a stock and a barrel for our sniper, for our sniper rifle. Let's store it. At least a little bit of most needed sorting has been done. So let's. Without sorting, I would never know that I had almost no 10 full weapons ready to use. Not a great quality, and I'm going to skills scavenging. I'm going to increase it. I'm going to spend the points because it takes too long. So 40, at least 40 to quality Joe. Scavenging 40. Why can I not loot quality? Scavenging 40. Oh, I forgot one. Yeah, now Joe. Because this will allow me, and I think at least it's going to be little bit more efficient. Allow me, for instance, go to get that treasure map, like Jennifer treasure map that we are going to get now. Where the hell is Jennifer treasure map? I think it's over here. Let's place a quick waypoint and go and get that treasure map with points spent on quality. And then again, let me just check if I have spent points, any kind of points in Treasure Hunter. Let me just buy the first one. For me, the first one is normally it's almost enough to be easier to get to the treasure. So let's go and get the treasure. Let's see if we get some nice missing weapon parts and wait for the airdrop that it's going to happen today. So let's go for a quick drive. Why the hell don't I have? Okay, I need to repair it. Don't have any batteries now. Okay. Lead battery. Why did it went all the way down? Okay. What I don't miss, what I have the most, it's batteries. I don't really know why that battery went dead. It's the first time it happens. Let's get a new one. Have a lot of batteries, so. But I didn't leave the light on, I think. It's so good to have stuff sorted. Okay, let me give me this one. And let's go. We get in this mod in all stages of wrenching cars batteries, so that's why I have a lot of batteries. Since I wrench a lot of cars to get the gas, it's really easy. I will try to show you if we come across a couple of cars, just to show you that in all stages of wrenching cars we can get batteries. We can get batteries. We have here one. What can I? Did I bring a wrench? Yes, I did. Any zombie here? Nope. Let's wrench there. Let's see if we can get a battery so that I can show you. Well, one of the changes of the mod, and I don't know if they did change or not. We are getting much more less stuff. Just 15 gasoline with this wrench. That's awful. But okay, I need to keep an eye on that. Normally, I get much more gasoline by wrenching the car. Let me also get this one. We have a bird over there. We are just, if you can see below, plus one gas in each wrenching, so that's not a lot. Plus two, plus one. Let me check here. See if that helps. Is always get the feathers, even if we don't need feathers for our repeating crossbow. Nothing special, three bullets, and that is my bike. Let's continue. Let's go to the Let's go to the treasure. From the desert to full winter in a couple of meters. That's wonderful. And I think this is burn biome, perhaps. No, it is just a small patch of wasteland and now desert again. Let's see if we have that treasure in the water, which can probably happen. But it's still far away, so. I'm going to do a quick pause, and when we reach the treasure, I will start recording. Here we are, my friends. We just arrived near where the treasure chest is. It's in the water, not too far, but it's in the water. So I've parked my bike here. Let's dive in. Lovely day to be swimming, so let's dive and get the box. It's just here. It's one of the advantages of having the treasure inside the water. It is that we don't need to dig any kind of to start digging anywhere, because if it's in the water you can get the treasure by just diving. The only problem that you have is you have to swim to the treasure. It's almost airdrop time. Let's see if, since we are in the water, we don't get unlucky and have the airdrop fall in the water. So I'm really trying to reach, get home, to get, sorry, get to dry land, so that we can quickly get also the airdrop. Last one, I think it was full of medical supplies. Let's hope this one is full of weapons. Other stuff that I've been thinking, it's with this last update, our wrench, it's really, really not that good. At least since I'm trying to wrench cars, I'm not getting any kind of gas. Let me just try again. Where the hell is the wrench? Hello, wrench, wrench, wrench. Here it is. We should really get much more gas. And the airdrop is not. What is the plan? Yeah. Water. Water. really my luck, and it was to be expected. Let me check here, bricks and stuff. Let me see this level. This level I also don't get any kind of real guess. Just I was having like plus 15 for each time that I wrenched the car, and now I'm getting just plus one, now this last level plus two. But even because I increased our perk of bad mechanic, but that's not that good. It's too much, too few gasoline. But okay, let's quick bike drive to that airdrop. It is over there. Let's go around here, and with that at least we get all of them. We get all of the this lake mapped out, so it's really nice to know the full size of the lake. And we also want to see after that always that we have an any kind of airdrop, we will be able to see if it's on dry land or if it is on the water. Can I go through here? This is almost a river. It's how nice. Really, really nice. If this wasn't in the desert, it would be a nice place to have a base. We have here a camp. And can the airdrop please be on land? It should be wonderful. That would be really, really wonderful. Land, please land. Yeah. Looking at the airdrop, it is here, just in the near the water. Really nice. Let's also check what's here, and an SMG M100, and I have the schematic. Nice airdrop. I was hearing a zombie. Let's check the bird's nest. I think one of the components in this mod to make the to make gunpowder, it's sulfur, I think, and one of the ways to get sulfur is with eggs. So we really need to find eggs, because it's one of the ways to have, and I can show you. I don't know if it's a change from the if it is a change from last patch, of it's always being like this. Gunpowder, we need coal, nitrate. This combination, it's always the same, but sulfur, it's sulfur powder. You can get it from eggs and from rotting flesh. So since we need rotting flesh, why not get rotting flesh from this guy? Can have gunpowder to make bullets to get more of these guys. Should be a nice sequence of events. Where the hell are we? Let me see in the map. And we can go here to a nicer biome. Well, what the hell? I like the desert because it has club iron, it has a lot of food, it has sand to make cement, but I really love trees, so let's move a little bit more to this side. Let me check. More seeds. I should really make a little farm. And just to finish off this episode. Why not loot a little bit? And this is a small place to loot. Let's loot it. Sometimes there is here gun safes, so. I always like to get all the iron that I can get. So. And we have here mushrooms and my stuff. Any zombies here? Or is it completely free? Yeah, it's completely free. That's nice. Let's pick up all the mushrooms. Why not? Since we are here, get all this stuff. No safe, unfortunately. And but three boxes. Let me just finish up with the mushrooms. I can get all of these nitrates, and I'm not in a really in the need of nitrate, but I can just eat these and open up these boxes. A toilet, why not? Really useful. Gun store. A new pistol and a cockroach. I was really hoping for a cockroach. And gun store, two gun stores, so that's nice. Repair kits, they are always nice. Let me get the mushrooms. Mushrooms, we can even plant them in caves. So perhaps I will start a little farm inside my base to make mushrooms because I need them for. Let me see what kind of recipes. In this mod, we can vegetable stew. I think it's almost the same, of not, or at least I think it's exactly the same as vanilla. Needs to. We all also need mushrooms. I don't know if vanilla. We also need mushrooms, and okay, we need them to antibiotics. So, yeah, we should have a small farm of mushrooms. Why not? And we are done, my friends. We are done for this episode. I'm just going to store right here all the stuff that I got. And what I will probably do, since I am here in the desert, I'm going to get a little bit more sand. Not this. I'm going to get a little bit more sand to really crank up the cement to improve our base. And that's it. I'm going to if I brought my shovel. Yes, I brought it. And we can get a lot of sand in this place. Yes, we can. And we got also, what the hell is this? Salt portion. We can get a tortilla, taco. I also should do, really do, an episode regarding food, because we have lots of new food in this mod and I haven't really taken a good look at it. I always get the regular stuff, so I really should take a really good look at what kind of food we can build or we can make in this mod. I hope you guys have enjoyed it. We have went to a treasure hunt, we got the airdrop, we built nice guns, and we checked the patch notes for this version of the Undead Legacy mod. I hope you have enjoyed it. Please join me in the next one. We are going to improve the base in my next episode, and until then, thank you. Just going home, I stumble across a roaming horde. Why not finish up nicely the video by killing some zombies? It's much better than just just treasure hunting, so let's gather around all of them right here so that we don't lose anyone. Please, my friends, come along over here. Over here. Please enjoy my lovely crossbow. Repeating crossbow. We have bolts for everybody. By lining them up like this, it looks like I don't have really such lousy aim because I missed the first one, and normally I can hit the guy behind them. So let me just get these guys over here also. Hello, my friends, I'm here. Yes, can you smell me? Please, let's move to the road again. And while I wait, let's check this multi-pack. This one. We should always end an episode with a roaming bird. It should be a requisite, not gathering sand. How the hell? How the hell it is nice to see some guy gathering sand. Now that, why are you leaving, man? Are you joking? Are you really joking? Man. Over here, to the road. Come to the road. Yes, hit the tree. That guy is so frustrated that it's hitting the tree. Stupid. Why the hell? Okay. I have cert. And that's a nice way to lose health. I hope one of these guys has something to drink. It could be really nice. Please don't shield a lot, man. That guy moves so much his head. Was a nice shot. And are we done? Yes, we are. Let's see if I can get any kind of food. Buzz coffee. Nope. Just I. The wrong kind of drink. Can she have any nice food? No, she was building something. We don't still have any kind of drink also. No drink. Drink, please. More junk. Well, how about a shotgun? Noodles, no either. Soap, why not? Brain freeze, yes. What I was really looking for, a brain freeze. And we are done, my friends. Now it's for sure. I hope to see you in the next episode.